In this lecture, I would like to discuss about the next topic of the chemical bonding, which is given in the syllabus, that is involvement of d orbitals in various types of hybridizations. In the previous lecture, we explained sp hybridization, sp2 hybridization and sp3 hybridization. We have taken the example of that type of the hybridization. In sp hybridization, we have taken the example of beryllium difluoride. In sp2 hybridization, we have taken the example of boron trifluoride. And in sp3 hybridization, we explain the sp3 hybridization with reference to methane molecule, CH4 molecule, and on the same time we derive their equations for that particular type of the hybrid orbitals. In sp hybridization, there are two hybrid orbitals, so two equations are there. In sp2 hybridization, there are three hybrid orbitals, so we know the three equations for that three sp2 hybrid orbitals. In sp3 hybridization, there are four sp3 hybrid orbitals and there are four equations. And on the same time, we also find out the coefficients of that equations. I would like to show, for example, sp3 hybridization. You can see here sp3 hybridization. So let us see sp3 hybridization. See, there are four equations: sp3 1, a1 psi s plus b1 psi pz plus c1 psi py and d1 psi px. And we derive their coefficients A1, B1, C1, and D1. Similarly for SP2, SP3, SP3, 4. So we know the method how to write the equation. We know the method how to derive the coefficients. Now let us going to discuss with reference to these hybridizations. With reference to these hybridization, few examples of these hybridizations. Later on, we will discuss this involvement of d orbitals in various types of hybridizations. So let us going to discuss first some examples related to the hybridization that is discussed by us. So let us see first sp hybridization examples. Okay, sp hybridization. So first one, it is sp hybridization. 1s and 1p orbital get combined and there is a formation of two hybrid orbitals. So for sp hybridization, we know the example, it is beryllium hydride. Second example, it is beryllium fluoride for sp hybridization or beryllium dichloride. Okay, difluoride and dichloride. So beryllium atom undergoes sp hybridization. Second, it is sp2 hybridization. sp2 hybridization. Example, it is boron trifluoride. The central boron atom undergoes sp3 hybridization, sp2 hybridization. And third, it is sp3 hybridization. Well-known example, it is methane molecule, CH4 molecule. Now, if we consider the sp3 hybridization, I would like to take another example belongs to this type of the hybridization. Now this is a AB4 type of the molecule. methane molecule. Let us take the example here, NH3 molecule. NH3 molecule. So in NH3 molecule, let us find out the hybridization of the central nitrogen atom. Let us find out the hybridization of the central nitrogen atom. So nitrogen atomic number 7, having the electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. Okay. So write the electronic configuration of the nitrogen in ground state first. Ground state. So this is the valence shell. So 2s atomic orbital, get and 2p atomic orbital. So first of all, represent the ground state here. So 2 electrons here and 3 electrons here. Okay. Now in NH3 molecule, as there are only 3 hydrogen atoms are covalently bonded to the nitrogen atom. And in the valence shell of the nitrogen atom, there are 3 unpaired electrons which are present, 3 half-filled orbitals which are present into the 2p atomic orbital. And these 3 half-filled orbital is having the 1 unpaired electron each. So the nitrogen in NH3 molecule undergoes hybridization. That is, let us show that hybridization here. 3 hydrogen atoms are covalently bonded to the nitrogen atom. So these 3 electrons or 3 half-filled orbitals, okay, let us show this. They can be shared with the 3 hydrogen atoms. Can be shared with the 3 hydrogen atoms. Okay, so this is 2s, this is 2p. And hybridization, it is sp3 hybridization. Nitrogen undergoes sp3 hybridization, but what happens here in case of the NH3 molecule? These 3 are the bonding pair electrons, means there is a direct bond here, covalent bond, sigma bond. And this 2s atomic orbital, means this orbital, one of the sp3 hybrid orbital is having the lone pair of the electron. So sp3 hybridization shows tetrahedral geometry. Let us show this. In NH3 molecule, the nitrogen, it is showing the tetrahedral geometry. So let us show this tetrahedral in this way. Bond angle, it is 109.5. And these are the 3 sp3 hybrid orbitals here. They can be overlapped with 1s atomic orbital of the 3 hydrogen atoms. This is 1s atomic orbital of the 3 hydrogen atoms. 3 hydrogen atoms get bonded with the nitrogen atom. So this is 1s atomic orbital of the 3 hydrogen atom, and there is a formation of the sigma bond between nitrogen and hydrogen. So in this way, 3 sp3 hybrid orbitals are used in the sigma bonding. One is remaining, but it is having the 2 electrons. That electrons are not called as a bonding pair electrons. So these electrons are called as lone pair electrons. Those electrons which are not used in the bonding, they are called as lone pair or on a shared pair electron. So thus in NH3 molecule, nitrogen is having 1 electron here. And the geometry of the molecule, it is sp3 hybridization. But due to the presence of this electron, the geometry becomes distorted to some extent. Okay, distorted to some extent, and nitrogen NH3 molecule shows pyramidal geometry. Pyramidal geometry. So even though hybridization is sp3, but geometry of the molecule, it is different. So this is about some examples where the molecules containing the lone pair electrons. Okay, let us going to discuss now the next topic, involvement of d orbitals in various type of hybridizations. So first of all, formation of sp3d then sp3d2 hybrid orbitals and sp3d hybridization. Formation of sp3d, now d orbitals are involved here. We know about sp3 hybridization. D orbitals are also involved in the hybridization. 1s 3p, 1s 3p, and 1d orbital get mixed up, and there is a formation of newly hybrid orbitals with equivalent energy. Newly hybrid orbitals with equivalent energy. So 5 hybrid orbitals are formed here. Now, this type of the hybridization can be explained by taking the example of AB5 type of the molecule. So it is phosphorus pentachloride, PCl5. So let us see, in PCl5 molecule, what is the type of the hybridization there? So phosphorus, it is having the atomic number 15, having the electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p5. So this is the valence cell. 5 electrons are there in the valence cell. So in the ground state, it has the electronic configuration. You can see here. The ground state, phosphorus atom in the ground state. Phosphorus atom is the central atom. In phosphorus pentachloride molecule, phosphorus atom, it is the central atom. And the atomic orbitals of the central atom undergoes hybridization. And that hybrid orbitals can be overlapped with the atomic orbitals of the chlorine atom. And there is a formation of the covalent bond. So let us see, phosphorus is having 3s2, 3p3 type of the electronic configuration. 3s2, 3p3 in the valence cell. Just see here. 3s2, 3p3. Hybridization will be here. So in the ground state. Now there, after 3p, 3d orbitals are also there. Because in phosphorus pentachloride molecule, 5 chlorine atoms are forming the bond with the phosphorus atom. So the central phosphorus atom should have five orbitals which have one unpaired electron. Now if you see the valence cell, 3 unpaired electrons are there, or 3 half-filled orbitals are there. But on the basis of the valence bond theory, as there are 5 bonds are existing between the phosphorus and 5 chlorine atom, so we require 5 half-filled orbitals. So therefore, phosphorus in the excited state, promotion of this electron into the next orbital, that is 3d. So this electron get shifted to the 3d orbital here. This shifting of the electron takes place because when the chlorine atom approaches to the phosphorus to form the bond, chlorine atom approaches to the phosphorus atom to form the bond, the energy is released. The energy is released, and due to that released energy, the electron from the 3s orbital promoted to the 3d orbital. Now you can see here, in the excited state, each orbital have the one unpaired electron, and each orbital, it is half-filled orbital. That is the excited state of the phosphorus. Later on, in the phosphorus pentachloride molecule, we can show the arrangement now. Central phosphorus atom undergoes hybridization, sp3d, 1s, 3p, and 1d orbitals get combined. So hybridization, it is sp3d hybridization in phosphorus pentachloride molecule. Okay. Now this is the electron from the chlorine atom. Okay, let us show. This is the electron from the chlorine atom. As there are 5 chlorine atoms are bonded, so the atomic orbital of the chlorine also get overlap with the 5sp3d hybrid orbitals. See, these orbitals are 5 orbitals. 5sp3d hybrid orbitals are formed there. So this is the arrangement. Okay, so in phosphorus pentachloride molecule, these electrons are the bonding pair electrons. Okay, so this is the sp3d hybridization in phosphorus pentachloride molecule. Okay, in phosphorus pentachloride molecule. So what is sp3d hybridization? Sp3d hybrid orbitals results from the combination of 1s, 3p and 1d atomic orbital of the valence shell of the central atom of a given molecule. There is a combination of 1s, 3p and 1d orbital. You can see 1s, 3p and 1d orbital of the valence shell, and there is a formation of sp3d hybrid orbitals. Okay, so see now, once the hybrid orbitals are formed, 5sp3 hybrid orbitals have the same shape and energy. They are having the same shape. All the orbitals are having the same shape and energy also. They are having the identical energy. Okay, so let us represent the geometry of the complex. As sp3d hybridization, it means that geometry of the complex, it is, see first, what is the shape of the sp3d hybrid orbitals? S orbital combined with 3p orbitals, px, py and pz, and one of the d orbital, that is dz square orbital. This dz square orbital, it is most suitable for the formation of the sigma bond. Now, after the combination of these three, you can see here, the 5sp3d hybrid orbitals have this type of the shape, where two hybrid orbitals are along the axis here, axial. A stands for axial. Two hybrid orbitals are along the z-axis. A stands for axial here. Okay. This is onto the axis. And B, it is equatorial position. If you join these three, there is a formation of equilateral triangle. So this is equatorial position. You can see here bond angle. Okay, so bond angle between this and this, it is 90 degree. The bond angle between this orbital and this orbital, it is 180 degree. Okay, and the bond angle between this and this, it is 120 degree. That is shown here in this diagram. So let us see now. The example, it is phosphorus pentachloride, trigonal bipyramidal geometry. See here, the two chlorine atoms onto the axis position and three chlorine atoms onto the equatorial position. Okay, and if we join them, there is a formation of the equilateral triangle. So from the above figure, it is clear that three equatorial chlorine atoms means this. This is the equatorial chlorine atom, acquires the equatorial position. This position, it is called as a equatorial position. Okay. This is equatorial position. And this position, it is the axial position. Two chlorine atoms are at the axis, along the side axis. Okay. So it is clear that three equatorial chlorine atoms at 120 degree bond angle. Bond angle, it is 120 degree there. And two apical chlorine atoms, means apical means this, axial, are at 90 degree. So the bond angle, it is here 90 degree between this. This is 90 degree bond angle. And axial chlorine atom in between this, 180 degree bond angle is there. Okay. So this is about sp3d hybridization. And the example, it is phosphorus pentachloride. Okay. So phosphorus pentachloride molecule, where central phosphorus atom undergoes sp3d hybridization, and corresponding geometry of the molecule, it is trigonal bipyramidal. दिस इज हैविंग ट्राइगोनल बाई पिरामिडल ज्योमेट्री, ट्राइगोनल बाय पिरामिडल, टू पिरामिड्स आर फॉर्मड हियर, ओके, अबव द दिस प्लेन एंड बिलो द प्लेन, टू पिरामिड्स आर देयर, इफ यू ज्वाइन दिस देर इज अ फॉर्मेशन ऑफ अ पिरामिड टाइप ऑफ द शेप, ओके, सो दिस इज ट्राइगोनल बाय पिरामिडल, ओके, इट इज हैविंग ट्राइगोनल बाय पिरामिडल टाइप ऑफ द ज्योमेट्री. Phosphorus pentachloride, it is having trigonal bipyramidal type of the geometry is here. Okay. So in this way we explain the phosphorus pentachloride molecule. Let us going to explain now formation of sp3d2 hybrid orbitals and sp3d2 hybridization. sp3d2 hybrid orbitals means 2d orbitals are involved into the bonding. sp3d2, how many hybrid orbitals are there? 6 hybrid orbitals, 1s 3p orbital, 2d orbital. So there is a formation of 6 hybrid orbitals here, okay. So it is explained by taking the example of ab6, where a is the central atom, and corresponding example it is sulfur hexafluoride. So sulfur hexafluoride, it is a very best example to explain the sp3d2 hybridization. sp3d2 hybridization. So see the electronic configuration of the sulfur, atomic number 16. Okay, so it is having the electronic configuration 1s2 2s2 2p6 and 3s2 3p4. So this is the valence shell 3s2 3p4. You can see 3s 3p. This is the valence shell. So in the valence shell only there are 2 half-filled orbitals. But in SF6 molecule there are 6 fluorine atoms forming the bond with the sulfur atom. So we require 6 half-filled orbitals are there. So therefore in excited state these electrons get promoted to the next orbital. Okay. From 3s orbital and from this 3p orbital. So therefore now there are 6 half-filled orbitals. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Each orbital is having the single unpaired electron. And in SF6 molecule, when the 6 fluorine atoms are approaches to the central sulfur atom, when the 6 fluorine atoms approaches to the central sulfur atom for the formation of the bond, like this we can show the structure will be in this way, okay. So sulfur atom undergoes sp3d2 hybridization. So let us see this sp3d2 hybridization, okay. So this is the arrangement for sp3d2 hybridization, and example it is sulfur hexafluoride molecule. Okay. So sp3d2 hybrid orbitals result from the combination of 1s, 3p and 2d atomic orbitals of the valence shell of the central atom of a given molecule. See, the diagram belongs to the hybridization. S orbital, 3p orbital, 2d orbital, that is dx square minus y square and dz square. These 2d orbitals are suitable for the formation of the sigma bond, so they are taken into this. Let us see the shape of the sp3d2 hybrid orbitals. A stands for axial and B should be at the corner of the square. So this is octahedral geometry. Bond angle here, this is 90 degrees. Okay, and between this axial 180 degrees. So this is the octahedral geometry for sp3d2 hybridization. For sp3d2 hybridization, geometry will be octahedral. So these hybrid orbitals can be overlapped with the atomic orbital of the fluorine atom. So in this way, six bonds are formed here. Six covalent bonds are formed here between the sulfur and fluorine atom. So in this way, sulfur atom undergoes sp3 d2 hybridization. 1s, 3p, and 2d orbitals are used in the bonding.